phylum Platyhelminthes. So when we talk about these Platyhelminthes, they are called flatworms. Flatworms. So we are going to talk about the general characteristics of flatworms. General characteristics. And we are also going to talk about the classification of Platyhelminthes and also the life cycle of representative species. So those are the things, and lastly, their economic importance, the adaptation, as well as the economic importance. So we are going to consider all this on this phylum Platyhelminthes. So let's start from the general characteristics, the characteristics of the Platyhelminthes. So as the name implies, flatworms, this group of organisms have soft body. Their body is very soft and they are dorsoventrally flattened. They have soft body. This group of organisms have soft body and they are dorsoventrally flattened. So this group of organisms are flattened, just like we have the cellulite. They are flat, very flat. So we also have another characteristics like their acylomates. And before we talk about the acylomates, they are triploblastic. They are triploblastic. Triploblastic. This simply means that their body is divided into three layers. The germ layers, primary cell layers, divided into three. That is the outer ectoderm, the middle mesoderm, and the inner endoderm. So those are the three parts. That's why I say they are triploblastic. That is a feature, that is an advancement over the period of the Cnidarians. We also said that they are acylomate. We said that this is three body division. Acylomate means that they don't have a true body cavity. They don't have a true body cavity, the Platyhelminthes. They are also bilaterally symmetrical. Bilateral symmetry. Their body has bilateral symmetry. That means that they can only, cut it along a single axis to have two, equal arms. So they have bilateral symmetry. They are unsegmented simply means that they don't have a segment in their body. The body is not divided into segments. And these organisms have single opening in their body. What do you mean by single opening? They have just a entrance, that is the mouth. They don't have anus, so they have incomplete digestive system. So this organism also lack special circulatory and respiratory system. So they don't have a respiratory system. However, movement of materials, oxygen, nutrient is carried by simple diffusion. So movement across the body occur by simple diffusion. So they don't have a special structure for respiration as well as circulation. This group of organisms also they are parasitic. They are mostly parasitic. and the parasite, ectoparasite, but few are free living. Few are free living, that is the planaria, free living. They are exclusively, they are mostly parasitic, but we have few that are free living. That is this group. What other characteristics? Since they are parasitic, those ones that are free living have some structure for movement. They can move from one place to another. But those parasitic have structure for attachment to their host tissue. So those are the characteristics of the platyhelminthes. We said they don't have special structure. They are sense organ in their, you know, young stage. They have sense organs present in the young stage. What other characteristics do they possess? So we have examples. Examples of platyhelminthes. But they are also mostly hermaphrodite. They are mostly hermaphrodite, so they carry out sexual reproduction by, you know, fusion of gametes, you know, cross-fertilization. That's how they carry out their sexual reproduction. And we said that simple diffusion is enough. They also have phlegm cell for excretion. They have phlegm cell for excretion. Simple diffusion is what they use for movement of materials in the body. And we said the examples of platyhelminthes are flatworms are the planaria, liver fluke, we have the blood fluke, we have the tapeworm. These are the examples of flatworms. These are the examples of flatworms. So what are the classification now? So let's talk about the classification of platyhelminthes. Classification of the platyhelminthes. We have three main classes. We have class Tobelaria. These are the Tobelariums. We have two, class Trematoda. Trematodes are the flukes. Trematoda, these are the flukes. And we have the Cestoda, that is the deep one. So we are going to talk about the characteristics of each of these class. The class Tobelaria now. The class Tobelaria are exclusively free living. These are free living, you know, flatworms. They are not parasitic. Free living flatworms. They are not parasitic ones. We said that they are mostly parasitic, whilst they are free living. So the free living ones are the planaria, Tobelaria. This bigger example is the planaria. So these ones have a delicate soft body. They have a delicate soft body. And as a result of all that, they are free living. Their outer part of the body consists of cilia for locomotion. They possess cilia for locomotion. So the outer body possesses cilia, and suckers are rarely present. They don't usually have sucker because they move from one place to another. Then they don't possess enterum and cuticle. Enterum are absent. They don't have enterum and they don't have cuticle. This group usually have sense organ in the adult stage. They have sense organ in their adult stage. An example of this group is the planaria. Planaria. So this is the class. Then the next class is the class trematoda. That is the class type of tubularia. We have the class trematoda. So let's say we have class trematoda now. The trematoda have the following characteristics. First of all, they are parasites. They are parasitic, either endo and endoparasite, and they are ectoparasite. Ectoparasite of animals. So they cause diseases. They cause diseases. They can be found inside the body. That is when we have it as endoparasite, as well as outside the body. That is when we have it as ectoparasite. And this group of Platyhelminthes, as a result of the fact that they are parasites, their body usually consists of sucker. They are, sucker. These sucker are used for attachment. The suckers are present on the head region for attachment. Sucker present on the head for attachment to the host. So these are the features because they are parasites, and they also have thick cuticle. And this cuticle, we say here they don't have a cuticle, but in this place they have thick cuticle. So that cuticle also help them for protection. They have thick cuticle for protection. So those are the characteristics of this group, and they don't have cilia. No cilia in adult stage. No cilia in adult. They don't have cilia in adult. This group have a thick cuticle for protection. And we said they don't have a cilia. And another characteristic is that the trematoda. Example of the trematoda is the fluke, the blood fluke. The fluke. That is the example of the trematoda. And they have an entero. We said cilia is absent. They have enteron. They have enteron. Enteron is present. Enteron is present in this group. And also the last example of trematode is the liver fluke. Liver fluke, that is the fasciola. Liver fluke, that is the fasciola hepatic. Fasciola hepatica. Fasciola digestiva. So we also have the blood fluke, schistosoma. Blood fluke. So the last group now is the cestoda. So let's talk about this class cestoda. When you talk about the cestoda, just like the trematoda, they are endoparasites. They are mostly endoparasites of invertebrates or vertebrates. Endoparasites of vertebrates. So they cause diseases for animals and they stay inside the body of the animal. That's why I said that they are endoparasites. And this group also have soft body, they are flat body, they are tape-like body, tape-like. You know, their body is just like a tape, but these ones have a leaf-like, you know, structure. The trematode have a leaf-like shape, but these ones have a tape-like shape. And another characteristic of the trematoda is that they have hook and sucker. Their body is divided into the head and the proboscis. You know, their body is divided into the head, body divided into the head. So we have tape-like body, tape-like body, and the body is divided into head and proboscis. Head and proboscis. So in the head region, we have the scholars produce the the sucker as well as the hook for attachment. The scholars, the head region possess suckers and hooks for attachment, suckers and hooks for attachment. So they get attached to the host tissue, to the host, so that they can, you know, get nutrients from the host. So they don't have guts. Yes, they don't have digestive system. They absorb digested food from the host directly. They don't have, so the already digested food will be, you know, siphoned from the host. So they don't have digestive system. And they don't have cilia, no cilia in adults. So it's really present to be the larval stage. So they are not motile, they don't move, they are attached to the host tissue. So what are examples of cestoda? Example of cestoda are tapeworm. And when you say tapeworm, okay, that is a tenia solium, and tenia segnata. So that is the classification of platyhelminthes and the characteristics of each of these classes.